we got the, you know, the PLA, the stainless steel, right, brass. I mean, basically, you can put your kennel in afterwards, but it's nothing like that because it's still heavy. You know.
Right. So you're familiar with the process?
I mean, the machining process, or
this is the powder feeder.
Oh.
So we put powder in the reservoir here. The little blender blends the powder up, puts it onto a little disc, and then the argon gas picks up the powder and then runs it into the laser.
Nice.
So we can do 1045 steel here, we can do 316 stainless over here with a second hopper here, and we can, you know, go back and forth on powder.
So how many materials can you do at one time?
On this particular feeder too.
Okay.
They do make feeders that have six.
Okay, so you do six materials, I guess.
Six different materials that you want. But for the first time we're taking one subtraction part out of a machine that would be completed with maybe two or three different alloys.
Now I was wondering, like, how long does it take to actually print something like
the part we're doing here?
Yeah.
Here's a setup. This is the steps that we're going through. I'm sorry to interrupt, Mike, but what's the total cycle time?
It's about an hour and a half.
About an hour and a half.
About an hour and a half for
from a billet to finish.
Nice.
With two different alloys.
Yeah. And you said y'all get an Econo?
Yes, it's Econo that we're burning on here right now.
Okay.
So Inconel, and then we finish turn it. And what's the interesting thing is you can't even tell the blends of the two different materials. So now the blade could be in service for a lot longer.
So how many axes is
it? It's a five axis.
Five axis.
So it's
got
trunnion table design.
Okay, trunnion. All right.
So yeah. 500 millimeter table, about 14 inch build height. Okay. Got a 1,000 kilowatt laser on it.
Nice. How much is something like this run?
About 5 1/4.